I hope you are staying at home now. Beta, how was your examinations? Have you given the examinations properly?
Okay.
Beta, in the last lecture, that is lecture number 6, I have explained you about the multiplications of a polynomials. But after a long time, we are meeting. So again, I am making you clear that what is polynomial. Polynomial means change of terms. Terms are expressed in the form with a number and a variable. Number can be any form, a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. And variable can be of many times, like a, b, c, up to x, y, and z. So, polynomial is a change of term. Now, the polynomial has been classified into terms as well as power form. What is term? Then a polynomial having a one term is known as monomial. A polynomial having two terms is known as binomial. Whereas polynomial having three terms is known as trinomial. That I have made you clear, but that is short reason for you. Now according to degree, polynomial having a one degree, means having a power one, is known as linear. Polynomial having a power two, that is quadratic polynomial. And polynomial having a power 3 is cubic. But what happens if you having a power of 4, then that polynomial is known as biquadratic polynomials. Hope you have understood that things. Then I made you understood how to multiply the things by putting up the values. Okay. Today in this lecture I am going to explain you how to multiply again, how to multiply the things. I have some questions for you. Then I am showing you how we will multiply it and we will get out the output. Okay, I am writing down the questions for you. It's over here. Question number 1, that is multiply. In the multiply part, I am doing two questions for you. That is ax square 3a plus 5 multiply with a plus 7. This is A. And the second one, I am making you clear that if we multiply 7x minus 3 multiplied with 2x plus 7. Now see over here, the question has been given to you, multiply means when you multiply, that is which term it is? It is C, it is three terms, that is trinomial. It is two terms, that is binomial. Okay. Now multiply trinomial with the binomial part. Now what we will do? See over here. First, we will multiply a square with both the terms. A into a square into a. A cube a square into 7. 7a square. Plus 3a into a, 3a square, 3a into 7, 21a. Now we will multiply with 5. 5 into a, 5a plus 5 3 is 5 7 done, 35. Now add the like terms. A cube will be a cube, 7 plus 3, it will be 10, a square, 21 plus 5, it will be 26, a, n plus 35. So this is the answer. What happened? I multiplied a square with both number. Then 3a with both number and 5 with both number. Then added the like terms with the each other. Okay? A square with a square, a with a, 35 is alone and a cube is alone. So it has kept alone over here. So this is cubic. So see, here the power is 3. So cubic polynomial. Now I am doing, because here all the signs were positive, so answer was positive. But here you can see when a binomial is divided with a binomial, multiplied, 7 2s are 14x into x, x square plus 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 7 7s are 49x minus plus minus 3 into 2x, that is minus 6x minus plus minus 21. 7 3s are 21. Now 14x square, 49 is positive but 6 is negative. 49 minus 6, it will be plus positive 43x, because sign of bigger number, what is the bigger number over here? Bigger number is positive. Minus 21. So this is an answer. What I have done, again I am saying you, I just multiply this number with this number, this number with this, then minus 3 into 2, minus 6, minus 3 into 7, minus 21. And then I just simplify that part. You have got the topic clear. This is the way to get the multiply part. Now I will make you understand how to do the simplifications part. This is question number 1. Then question number 2, I will make you understand how to do the simplifications.
Okay.
Now I am just erasing this part. Hope you are getting it clear. Now in question number 2, I will make you clear how to do the simplifications. You will get the entire question very clear in the question number 2. Now see, I have erased the board over here. Now see question number 2. The question number 2 is simplify. Simplify means we have to solve. I have written writing down the questions over here. Question number 2, that is simplify. I am solving two questions for you. Number 1, that is x plus y multiply with 2x plus y. Here is plus, then x plus 2y and x minus y. See the questions over here. Everyone, just have a glance for the questions. Okay, the first question and the second question is over here. Then I am solving the second question, that is x minus y, x square plus xy plus y square. This is the second question. I have written down the questions over here. Now this is the simplify part. Simplify part, what we will do? We will just multiply these two things first. These two things. Then we will add the according to the like terms. But we will keep it in the bracket part so that it will be convenience for us. Okay? I am solving. We just look at over the board part. See over here. I am making a curly bracket. X into 2x, that is 2x square, x into y, xy, 2x into y, 2xy, plus y into y, y square. I just put the curly bracket over here. This was in first part, simplified. Then again curly bracket, x into x square, plus minus, will be minus, x into y, xy, 2y into x, that is 2xy, then plus minus 2y into y, 2y square. Now we will first do the simplifying over here. I am putting a small bracket. 2x square. Now see 2xy plus 1xy, because nothing is over here, then it is 1. 2xy plus 1xy, that is 3xy. Sorry, the bracket will be plus y square, then bracket. Here again I am putting a small bracket, x square. Now you see plus 2y minus 1y will be plus xy minus 2y square. Now we will remove the bracket. I am removing the bracket, it is here plus, so So none of the sign will be changed. But if there will be minus, then entire sign of the bracket inside the bracket will be changed. Here 2x square 3xy plus y square plus x square plus xy. This is xy and minus 2y square. Now I am doing additions. 2y square, 2x square plus x square, it will be 3x square, 3yxy plus 1xy, 4xy minus 2 plus 1 will be minus x square. So this was your first part answer. Hope you have understood these things. What I have done, first I simplified these two things, then I simplified these two things, then we have done the simplifications of the like terms. 2xy plus 1xy, 3xy, 2xy minus xy will be plus xy because sign of the bigger number is positive. Then I added down the like terms together. Now in this sum, I will multiply first x into x square, x cube, x into xy will be x square y, x into y square, xy square. Now with the minus 1, minus x square into y, x square y, minus xy square, and plus minus will be minus y. I just multiply x with the entire number, this one, then y with the entire number, this one. Now, look at the things. What have we done? Plus x square y minus x square y will be cancelled because plus minus can be cancelled. Plus x y square minus x y square is cancelled. So what we have got, x cube minus y cube, this is an identity. X cube minus y cube is x minus y, then bracket x square plus xy plus y square. So this is a way to get out the simplifications of the polynomials. In the first questions I have done the multiply, in the second questions we have done the simplification. Simplifications, what we have done, we multiply and add it, so it becomes a simplified part. This is the way to get out the sums. Hope you have understood the topic clearly. Related to this, I have given some sums for practicing. Please stay at home, stay healthy. Thank you everyone.